Hey everybody, welcome back inside the Mind of Matt. It's such a beautiful day. I've stepped outside away from the 3D printer, and if you've been watching my videos, I made some things out of styrofoam, put them in some sand, and the plan was to melt some aluminum and pour it on top. Well, the weather hasn't been nice because, if you didn't know, I live in snow country, so he said it's nice enough, so I'm outside, and it's time to make some fire. Here's a little quick view of my setup. I'm running propane, and this is a weed burner I got from Arbor Freight. My crucible. There's an old fire extinguisher. This is my foundry. Just bought a cheap little metal garbage pail from a home improvement store. Got me some plaster Paris and some sand and made it up. Somewhere I've got some video buried, I think, of me actually making it before my channel actually started. There's my lid, which I had to redo once. Put some reinforcements around. If you see, there's some wire that I drilled holes and kind of weave some wire through it before I poured. In my cup, that actually works great as a nice little chimney. My draws pan, my spoons, and of course, this is what we're going to be pouring. If you go back to the videos, you'll see it's kind of a potluck. I didn't really keep track of what was where, so there's some boots and some anchors, and oh geez, I can't even remember what the other ones. This is my ingot tray that I made, some angle iron, just welded it up. Makes nice little ingots like this. And before that, I was using a muffin tin, and that kind of got disintegrated. Here's a failed print. He's gonna go in there first, melting that down. So, all right, I'm gonna finish getting set up here. We're gonna fire this bad boy up and melt some aluminum.
So once again, folks, I gotta remind you that this is a dangerous thing that I'm doing. This is very hot. This is gonna be over 1100 degrees Celsius. All right, I have protective gloves. I have double layered pants on. I have steel toed leather boots on, and I've got a face shield that needs to be cleaned. That needs to be cleaned, in case you couldn't hear that. But safety is first. So make sure that you're wearing protective things and you're doing this in an environment where there's nobody around that's going to be getting hurt. So, and if you do this, just remember you're doing it at your own risk. So stay tuned and enjoy.
Now it's going to be hard to talk once I get going here, so it's just going to be a visual, and I'll try to get some close-ups as best as I can, but right now I'm alone and I don't have my cameraman yet, so all right, here we go. Get a little closer to the fire. Well, we're just warming up. So in order to save space and battery life, I got the other camera running. So it'll be the best production I can do given the circumstances that I'm working with extremely hot stuff, and you know, being a cameraman at the same time isn't really conducive with being safe. So
here we go. So, if you notice, my heat gun only goes up to 1,000 degrees. We're already at 860 something, so a little bit and we'll have some molten aluminum. My buddy's supposed to be coming, and he's going to be bringing me his temperature gun, and it goes a lot higher than mine does, so hopefully he'll get here soon and we'll be able to get some readings on his. Anywho, we're progressing. He's melting soon. It's only been about 10-15 minutes.
I'm hitting an error, so that means I'm over 1,000 degrees. So at this point, we should start to see some aluminum start to melt.
I don't know if the camera's gonna pick it up. Maybe it is. That's molten aluminum down there. We're getting there. Biggest thing about this, guys, don't rush it. I had a failure on one of my crucibles before. And it turned out, I figured out what was happening as I was pushing, prodding, and that steel outside shell of my crucible was weak because it was nice and warm, and I caused my own failure. So just be patient and it'll melt. Pretty hot. Oh, you see it? Melting.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce to you one of my most specialist guests you'll ever meet. This is my best friend in the whole world, Richie Gass.
How's
What's
it going?
Up, buddy? Hopefully, hey. He brought me a present. And he's got it right there in his hand. And mine only goes up to 1,000 degrees. I'll show you what happens. I get an error. Now Richie's.
Oh, that is hot.
Is it exceeding yours?
Exceeding mine.
Oh, wow. That means it's pretty hot, guys. I definitely have, let's open this puppy up.
All right, I got a cameraman now, so I can kind of work the camera and the forge as well. So we're gonna open this up and you should see how far we've got. So come on in here, cameraman.
Look at that.
Probably gonna be it for that pour, and as soon as that melts down, we'll stir it around, get rid of the dross, and then we're gonna do our first pour. So stay tuned. Right, we've got to get in here and do a little stirrage. The impurities, we're gonna end up rising to the top. Some of this is some of the old slag and stuff that was from the last melt. We just got to get rid of some of this off yucky stuff. We'll be pouring here in a couple minutes, so.
And if you haven't followed along, this is styrofoam, and this process here is called lost foam casting, and this probably, maybe, the last styrofoam pour that I do, I said do, but no, because with the 3D printer, and I'm going to attempt to do some lost PLA casting, so that's kind of the whole purpose of getting a 3D printer, so that I can make my own objects easily with the printer versus, you know, trying to carve something out of styrofoam. We're getting really close here. I'm gonna have to get my degasser and my degrosser stuff out, and we're gonna be pouring these two first, and I need then these two, three next probably. Those guys, I need the cans from them, and those guys, I need the sand and the cans from them. So it's gonna be a little bit of a switcheroo kind of thing. It'll be fun to watch. So still got the camera up there recording. Gonna do some cool overlays, so have a good time here on this beautiful Saturday afternoon in upstate New York.
A little bit of gas, so there's some leftover from the last time. Washing soda. Did some research on it. Not sure exactly. Some potassium saccharate or some kind of scientific name up in there, but you see what it's doing? It's releasing the hydrogens. Okay, you guys need to back up, please. We got pure molten aluminum. This is where the dangerous part comes in. This guy's gonna go over here. Worked out pretty good, actually. I felt pretty secure about that. We'll get the fire going back up. Some more stuff up. for a chat here. Closer to being horrible, so let's take a look. Oh yeah, look at that. Well, there was a lot more impurities on the last pour. I still had what was the remnants of the last pour still left in there, so there was still impurities. But this one, this stuff's already been melted down, and all the impurities have been taken out of it. So it's almost pure aluminum that I'm melting back down. So that's why you're not going to see a lot of waste in this one. But I'm going to do a little degas, and we'll get ready to pour this.
So I just got me some scrap aluminum foil I stole from the kitchen. And this is, like I said, it's washing soda. Just got it at the hardware store. Just take a little bit of them out like that. Because I'm already melting aluminum, this is just going to add to the mix. So, and the key is to get it all the way down the bottom. That's why you saw my little tool. So come on over here with me, Richard.
Keep them all in, might as well. This stuff has still got a little of the remnants left on it, so it's going to activate even better. So. I'll warm this up a little bit, and it just a lot of the stuff will come right off. Now, I wanted to talk about this next placement of these three, that if they weren't in a shell that I put them in, placing them this close, the temperature of this might just melt the others, creating a collapse. But because they've got a protective shell, I'm hoping that it's going to prevent that. So we'll see. I think there might be enough for this one. Push our luck, huh? I was holding my breath there for a little bit if you saw that. Gotta be prepared for what's going on here. All right. Now, due to what we've discovered, that this sand is maintaining its temperature for quite a long time, for the length of this video, I'm gonna kind of not pour anymore, and we're gonna do a little bit of clean up here and kind of call it a day for this particular pour. But I hope you have enjoyed it this far, and don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, hit that notification so that you'll get a little alert when my next video is coming, and just keep coming back. Don't forget, if you want to see something make, write it down in the comment. And thanks again for stopping inside the Mind of Matt.